Welcome to Dubai, 47. Today is the inauguration of the Scepter, and the ceremony is well underway. You will find Marcus Stuyvesant near the building's signature art installation. While a paranoid Carl Ingram has ensconced himself in his penthouse suite, security on highest alert. Mr. Gray is already in position and ready to assist. Good luck, 47.
47. Come in, 47. Do you copy?
I'm here.
Are you in position?
I'm heading towards the point of entry.
Good. Get back to me when you're there. Use your camera and scan the lock, will you? I think I can override the window's controls from here.
I'm in position.
47, the inauguration is taking place close by. Once you've infiltrated it, get your bearings. I'm sure there must be floor plans somewhere.
Understood.
We need absolute focus on this one. If Ingram and Stuyvesant are alerted to our presence, we may lose them for good. We are so close, 47.
Don't worry. They're not going anywhere.
Welcome.
Listen, I want to talk to the partners directly. Make them understand why all of this is happening. And that terminal gives me an idea. There's a server room near the Sheikh's personal reception. If you can gain access to it, we might be able to recover useful intel from it. We'll have to work together to hack the system, but it's our best shot. It looks like the staff area could provide you with a viable route to the server room.
Any news on the new guard assigned a codename Pinky?
I got word that he entered the building, but he hasn't reported for duty yet.
Probably still down at the depot, getting his uniform. I just hope he's got his papers with him.
I heard rumors that he used to work for that Dawood Rangan. You know, the Bollywood producer who died?
Doesn't sound promising.
Nope, it doesn't.
Stuyvesant is expecting a replacement guard. If you can locate him, we should be able to get within strangling distance of the little worm.
colleague is also out there looking.
But this is awful. I mean, I'm in my boxers and you are a woman. It's just so embarrassing.
Oh, it's nothing I haven't seen before.
But you don't understand. I'm military.
Hey, military medic.
Reporting for duty.
About time. Our client has been going out of his mind waiting for you. Do you have the papers?
Yes.
Good. I'll call him now.
How should I address him?
It's classified, so you don't call him anything. But officially, he's just known as codename Pinky. Sir, this is security. Just calling to let you know your new guard has finally arrived. Yes, sir. See you soon. Okay. Wait here. He'll be here shortly. Mumbai. I heard that was a shitstorm. It's good to see a man like you back in the saddle.
Must be my new escort.
Looking good today, sir.
I have very high standards, and trust you will do your duty. You have your credentials on you? Well, this all looks very promising. Yes. Good. Oh, you worked for Dawood Rangan. Hope you weren't there on the day of his tragic death. Okay. This all looks very good. Okay, walk with me. I need to go through some ground rules. I expect you to be by my side 24/7, unless I say otherwise. Bathroom breaks are, of course, permitted, but only when I say so. I have a very important, delicate meeting today, at which I expect you to keep your ears closed, but your eyes wide open. Understood? Now, your papers were indeed impressive, but I need to see what you can do with my own eyes. My father used to take me hunting. He was an avid hunter. I personally hated it, but always admired his skill with a knife, and grew to appreciate what it takes to gut an animal. Have you ever tried to gut an animal?
Yes.
Good. Then you know it's not so easy as it looks. Like trying to stab a rubber ball. It bounces back if you don't stab it correctly. You're almost here. You have to understand. I didn't get where I am by blind. Okay, we are almost there. You see the shooting targets? Any fool can shoot a target. With a knife? That's where the talent lies. My father always used to say, if you are good with a knife, you're even better with a gun. I want to see your skills. I don't know why, but I've always trusted a man to throw a knife. I'm sure a psychiatrist would have a field day with that statement. So, show me what you got. Do well and you work for me. Fail, you get out of here and I never want to see your face again. It's just always half as good as you were.
Only time will tell. But I doubt.
You cocky idiot. Oh, spot on. Spectacular. That was a magnificent performance. I like you. I think we will get along just fine.
You've gained his trust.
I think I got the right man now.
What to do
Thank
with all that power?
I'll take the rest of the day off. You deserve it.
Thank you, sir. It was an honor. Thank you, sir.
You impressed me. let's get to work. Some things you should know about me. This is very much on a need-to-know basis. I'm here incognito. So I want you to stay close.
You got him, 47. Marcus Stuyvesant won't be a problem anymore. Let's move on to Carl Ingram. We're not done yet.
There is something in it for you as well. I'm just kidding.
Hello, sir.
Just a precaution.
I've been personally invited by the Royal Highness Omar al-Ghazali. I should have clearance. The name is Zainab Kazim.
Sir, I understand, but you can't enter without being searched.
Zainab Kazim, aka the Vulture. One of the top agents working for Crystal Dawn, the Pan-African terrorist organization. I almost hired him myself once, but chose the Maelstrom instead. Now what is his business here?
It's standard procedure.
This is ridiculous.
Well, that's how it is. Think about it, and come back if you want. I'll be waiting upstairs in the reception. Understood?
Crystal.
What?
Thank you. see you. If you want to pass, you need to comply to a frisk, sir.
This is just standard procedure. Just a formality.
Right, that's it. Keep moving, please.
Oh, Mr. Kazim. I'm glad you changed your mind.
Arrogance can be a dangerous trait.
Yes, indeed, it can. Mr. Ingram has been expecting you. We have a conference room set up for you.
How you been?
And make yourself comfortable. Mr. Ingram will be with you shortly.
Thank you.
What's up?
Mr. Kazim, a pleasure to meet you. Omar tells me great things about you. I'll get straight to the point. I have a, well, let's call it a dispute, which the Royal Highness tells me you're very capable of taking care of. Now, I've worked with your organization before, in Morocco, I believe, so I'm a little hesitant.
Don't be. We do what's needed.
Well, only time will tell. I have two assignments for you. Take care of the first one, and then we can discuss the bigger fish. Now, on to the first. An acute problem has been brought to my attention.
Keep talking.
I'll be candid with you. No one is supposed to know that I'm here. However, there's a journalist down at the inauguration, and he's asking rather intrusive questions about who's staying up here, and that is a very dangerous problem for me. Now, I want you to silence this little pain. You think you can do that?
It's what I do best.
I like your bluntness. This is his file. Hans looked. Pulitzer-winning freelance journalist. He's good, and won't give up until he gets the answers he needs. And that can't happen.
Consider it done.
Good man. And remember, I want a picture. I want proof so I can sleep tonight.
Of course.
Once this little assignment is completed, come back and talk to Miss Toe. Then we can discuss the real cancer that needs to be removed. I'm sure you can see yourself out.
How are you?
excuse me. I was wondering if you could help me. Upstairs, that is the Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali's private penthouse. Correct. I heard rumors he has some guests of some significance. Now, I understand you probably signed an NDA, but I may be able to make up for it with cold cash.
Sir, I suggest you stop asking these questions. I will have to contact Central to escort you out.
All right, thanks for your help.
This stinks of something.
Hey, bud.
Good afternoon. This is quite the ceremony. I was thinking, upstairs, as I understand, it's the Royal Highness's private penthouse. It must be quite the view up there. Do you think you could get me access to that? I mean, it would really make my day.
Sorry, I have no idea. You should talk to security. I just work down here.
Okay, thanks.
Mr. Lund, I hear you're looking for information.
Oh, really? Okay. You know what's happening upstairs?
I know more than you could imagine. But we can't talk here. Follow me.
Great. Lead the way.
How you been?
Where are you taking me? I'm sure we passed plenty of places where we could talk. I hope it's worth it. This better be good. I have a reliable source that the Royal Highness Omar Al-Ghazali is keeping a secret upstairs. You don't talk much, do you? Where are you taking me? Something big must be going on since you're taking so many...
Wait for me here. I'll be back as soon as possible.
All right. Whatever it is, better be good.
Yes, that's it. Now Ingram trusts you, it's like shooting fish in a barrel.
And how are you today, sir?
Just keep calm.
Mr. Kazim, welcome back. So, you have the picture?
Yes, here.
Good. Our guest will be delighted. Please follow me. He's waiting. Mr. Kazim, please, follow me. Apologize about the incident earlier downstairs, but you have to understand that we need to keep security tight. No matter what, all our guests go through the same
Do
you like the building? This has been His Royal Highness's dream. I think for even longer than I have known him. Everything here is completely self-sufficient. Electricity, internet, even water is cleaned and reused. It's the first of its kind on this scale. It was important for him to look to the future. Mr. Ingram is expecting.
Mr. Cassie, so good to see you.
That's Carl Ingram, Provident's partner and brass-balled billionaire. A legendary political fixer, Ingram is old money and as rotten as they come.
Yes. Your problem is fixed.
Omar said you were good. Let's get down to the important business at hand. Okay, people, clear the room. I need to discuss some delicate business with Mr. Kazim.
Sorry. We have Ingram right where we want him.
Yeah, I just remembered something.
47, you know what to do.
Have a drink, see the view. It's something to behold.
Looking fine today, sir.
I'm sorry about that. Now, where were we? Now I know. My man here will stay for the meeting. I assume that will not be a problem. Either way, you have no choice in the matter. It's interesting we haven't come across each other before, Mr. Kazim. Well, maybe not. I usually have my people talk to people like you.
I can imagine.
I don't know how much Omar, I mean, the Royal Highness, has told you. But my guess is very little, so let me get straight to the point. My organization has been hit by an unpleasant cancer that can only be removed by cutting it out of the gut, if you get my drift.
Yes, I do.
Good. This little turd is spreading his vile, toxic cells, and I want him stopped. Brutally. Chemo won't remove him. Only the knife. I have his file here. Arthur Edwards. A sly little devil, if there ever was one. Me and my associates, well, we underestimated the little worm. We want revenge.
I think you and I share a common interest.
I doubt that. But I want you to make him suffer. This is not a horse that needs to be put out of its misery. This is a rabid dog that needs to be put down. Am I making myself clear, Mr. Kazim?
Yes. Consider it done.
Good. We're now in business.
We are.
I'll have Miss Toe send you anything you need. We're done here. Oh, one last question. I'm just curious. You're nicknamed the Vulture. Why?
I find it's best to wait for the perfect kill.
I think you'll be perfect for the job. Nice to meet you, Mr. Kazim. I look forward to receiving an update. Safe hunting.
Guard!
Yes, Mr. Ingram?
Please show Mr. Kazim out.
Yes, sir. Mr. Kazim, please follow me. Mr. Kazim, you need to listen to me. Follow me and don't get sidetracked. Mr. Kazim, you need to listen to me. Follow me and don't get sidetracked.
Listen here, pal. I'm sorry, but you're not getting through.
Hi there.
Hello, sir.
Hey, you! Where do you think you're going? Definitely not through here. Get out of my face.
Hello there, sir. Sorry, sir. Can't let you through here. Not happening.
Rangan guy. Never asked me to work for him. Calls me. I put in my CV.
Yeah. Hey.
It's just a drink. You don't mind, do you? Oh, I really think you are putting on a brave face. You shouldn't be hiding back here. You should be out there celebrating life. Oh, now that reminds me, I'm supposed to talk to Richard Voltaire. You know, I'm really frightened of him. His review on the Senses exhibition was brutal. But I'd rather be here supporting you.
Thank you, but it's really not necessary. I have...
Oh, don't be silly. I'm here for you. But, you know, I also do want to talk a little shop. I have an idea for the next exhibition. You are gonna love this.
Lucy. Seriously, could you please just give me a half an hour alone? I need to think.
You know, Cornelia, I really worry about you. Oh, wow. Oh, do you see that? Oh, just a sec.
Thank you. are you?
Tomorrow?
I got it. I'll get issued one tomorrow morning.
You know how it works?
I don't care.
Because I don't.
It's easy. Two of us are stationed up here and below, by the card reader. We get an alert, we both swipe our cards, and bingo. Lockdown.
But what if the other guard is using the bathroom?
Well, it's timed. So if that should happen, I should be able to run down and activate the other swipe as well. But I guess that will need a little practice.
Happy to not be at work tomorrow. Sounds like a lot of running around.
It's what we're paid to do.
Yeah, and it'll probably never happen. Just like fire drills.
Yeah. Just like fire drills. Good today, sir.
Are you kidding me? No, it's similar.
The relationship between them and their output.
Van Gogh would have been anything without him.
My wife is going to love this.
It's time. Better start preparing.
Man, a cup of coffee would be nice.
Hey, you can't throw things around. Find a garbage can.
hate to eat alone. Would you join me?
I'm not hungry, but I will happily keep you company, sir.
How you doing?
Lo and behold, everyone was all of a sudden, what's the word? Oh yeah, foodies. Suddenly everyone was a big shot chef. An insulting profession, yes. Interesting. Well, that was delicious. Thank you. Better get back to work.
It was a pleasure, sir.
Okay, rolling.
To my successor.
Out of my way,
power,
kiddo.
Power is not to be taken for granted. Where many have failed during the course of your... Hello.
Yeah, I just wanted to remind you about the lockdown.
What?
Who the hell left that thing?
Please stay back.
We got on 47. Soon there will be no more Providence. You need to find an exit. Our business is done here, but it's far from over.